Good morning, students. In the last class, we started doing these factors affecting climate. This figure we have done in the last class, children, which shows the latitudes, that is the torrid zone and temperate zone and frigid zone, which I have explained. Then we have also done about that on the equator, the rays of the sun fall vertical, and on the poles, the rays of the sun are slanting, due to which at the equator, the temperatures are high and the pressure is low. And in the last class, we have also done about the winds, which are called as trade winds. You can see here, we have started with this last class, trade winds, which I have shown you. The winds which are blowing from the tropics, that is subtropics, to the equator, they are known as the trade winds. I am showing them again, children. The winds which are blowing from Tropic of Cancer to equator, and the winds which are blowing from Tropic of Capricorn to equator. These winds are called as trade winds. Children, these winds which are blowing from the Tropic of Cancer to the equator, these are also called as northeast trade winds. They are also called as northeast trade winds, and India lies in the path of these winds. We all know where is India located. Roughly, we all also know that this is Tropic of Cancer, and Tropic of Cancer passes through the center of our country, that is middle of our country. So if I have to roughly draw our India, so the India's location is here. So half part is below the Tropic of Cancer and half part is above the Tropic of Cancer. So these winds which are blowing here, these winds are called as the northeast trade winds also, which I'll be doing more in the next part, children. So let's move on to the next figure or the next factor. Till now we have done the factors like latitudes, altitude, pressure and winds. In the last class, I have described how the pressure and wind system works when the winds blow from high pressure to low pressure, children. Now, we are doing the next factor, that is ocean currents. First of all, children, how many of you know what is an ocean current, how it rises? An ocean current, children, is a continuous directed movement of sea water generated by number of forces. These currents which rise from the sea, they are due to number of forces acting upon the water, including wind, the Coriolis effect, breaking waves, changes in temperature, change in the salinity differences. All these become the causes of ocean currents. And these ocean currents also affect the climate of a place. For example, there are two types of ocean currents. If the current is rising from a warm region, that is called as a warm current. And from wherever it passes through, that warm current, wherever that warm current passes through, that region will become warm. In the same way, there is a cold current, the current which rises from the colder regions. You can see here, there is an index also given here. in the red color, whatever is the red color is showing. Children, here I think the small one, you can see the index here. In red color, it is warm current. In blue color, it is cold current. So, whenever the warm current, from the warm region, a current is rising up, wherever that current is passing through, that region becomes the warm. In the same way, when the cold current rises, wherever that cold current is passing, that will become the cold region. It will make the temperature down, that is. So, you can see few of the warm current regions. For example, this is your warm current region. Then this is your warm current region. You can see here, this is your warm current region in red color. And then you have some of the blue colors also, which you can see here. For example, this is your blue color, which is your cold current. Then here we have the cold current over here. Then on the western part of this, you can see western part of America, you have the cold current. So that's how you will see the cold and the warm currents also affect the climate of a place. Then children, we will do in general distance from the sea, which I think in the last class I didn't do it. Distance from the sea. Now you can see this, these all are the regions which are, you can see that the a lot of water bodies are there over here. So any region which is near to the coastal area, any region which is near to the coastal areas, it can be Indian coastal areas. For example, we know that India, on the three sides of India, we have the coastal areas. I know that I am trying to draw this map, not completely. So, let's do this. On this side, we have children, Arabian Sea. We all know this. India is surrounded by water on three sides. So, we have, this is an example of India. We can take any example. We can take example of Africa, we can take example of America, any country's example which is surrounded by water. So, this is your, this is your Arabian Sea. Then here we have children, Bay of Bengal. I'm just writing B, and we know that here we have the Indian Ocean. So, we have water on three sides of our country. That is why we also called India as a peninsular country. So, I am talking about now the coastal areas. These coastal areas, which are on the coastal region. For example, Mumbai is a coastal area, Calcutta is a coastal area, Chennai is a coastal area. So, all these coastal areas, in these coastal areas, we have moderate type of climate. Now, what do you mean by moderate type of climate? Moderate type of climate means the temperature is neither very high nor the temperature is very low. That type of climate is called as moderate climate. So, near the coastal areas, it will be moderate climate, which I have shown you just now, which are the coastal regions of our country. So, by an example, now, the regions which are far away from the country, far away from the sea. Say, for example, when I talk about the northern plains or when I talk about the central plateau region, these are the regions which are far away from the coast. In these regions, which are far away from the coast, you will find extreme climate. I am repeating. Regions which are far away from the coast, you will find extreme climate. Children, this extreme climate can also be called as continentality. This also is called as continentality, continental type of climate. Like as I told you, in northern India and in the central highlands or in the central part of India, we have extreme climate or continentality. Now, what is extreme climate? The temperatures will be very high or the temperatures will be very low. For example, in northern plains, you might have seen the temperature in summers goes very high. It is sometimes 45, 47 degrees Celsius also. But in winters, temperature drops down even to 3 degrees and 4 degrees Celsius also in the northern plains. So, the temperatures are either very high or very low. But in the coastal areas, when I am talking about the coastal areas, the temperatures are moderate. Now, what is the moderate temperature? The day temperature may be 35 degrees and the night temperature may be 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. So, there is no much difference between the day and the night temperature or maybe the summer temperature or the winter temperature. There is no much difference. That is what is the moderate climate. I hope, children, you have followed. So, near the coastal areas will experience moderate climate. Far from the sea, that is like northern plains, which are far from the sea, we have extreme climate, which is also called as continentality. Now, that completes your one more feature, children. So, we completed latitude, altitude, pressure and wind system, distance from the sea and ocean current. We come to the next factor, that is, children, relief. Relief of a place. Now, what is the meaning of relief, children? Topography, that is, plains, plateaus, mountains, which we talk about. That is what is your relief features. So, how do a relief feature affect the climate of a place? For example, children, you can say that this is a hill, a mountain which you can see over there. Now, these mountains, for example, let us take Himalayas. Suppose these are the Himalayan mountains. Himalayan mountains act as a barrier for the cold winds. They act as a barrier for the cold winds. Now, if I talk about any mountain in the world, it can act a mountain. In general, a mountain can act as a barrier for hot wind as well as a cold wind. Now, what do you mean by barrier? Barrier means something which stops. So, these mountains will stop those winds because they are very high. So, when I talk about Himalayas, they stop the cold winds which are blowing from Central Asia towards our country. From Central Asia towards our country. Now, what are the Central Asian countries? For example, Kazakhstan. If you see the world map below the Russia, we have a place called as the Kazakhstan. And from those regions, the winds which are blowing, they bring the cold winds. So, the Central Asian part is very cold. But our northern part of India is not very cold. When I talk about very cold, it is completely a cold desert. If these mountains would not have been there in India, then our northern part of India especially would have been a cold desert. But it is not so because these mountains, they are acting as a barrier. They may cause precipitation if they are high enough and lie in the path of rain-bearing winds. If suppose the winds are rising, you can see the winds here. The winds are rising from the water bodies. So, this side of the winds, again I am showing, children, wait, with a different color so that it is clear to you. These winds which are blowing in this part of this mountain hill. This part of the mountain hill is called as, children, windward side. It is called as windward side. Windward side means the side which is receiving these winds. This region is receiving the winds because of which this region will get lot of rainfall. It will get lot of rainfall. So this region is called as windward side. So for any every mountain, every hill, there will be two sides of a hill. One will be called as windward side, which will receive the winds, which will bring the moisture or the rainfall to that region. The other part which is not receiving the winds, children, this part now I'm showing with the blue color, this part which is not receiving the winds, because this is in the other side, because these are mountains are very high, they do not allow the winds to cross them. So the other side of this mountain, it is called as, children, leeward side. LEEWARD. It's opposite to windward. WINDWARD. So this side it is windward, which is here it is written as wind. So with that you can remember, this is your windward side and this is your leeward side, children. This leeward side is also called as rain shadow area. It is also called as rain shadow area. It doesn't get rain, but definitely it gets the effect of that. Maybe it may get the cooler effect. For example, you might have seen somewhere if it is raining. Suppose it is raining in somewhere in some parts of the Delhi also. The other regions also get that effect. Maybe the rain is not there, but get the effect. Same way, this is called as a rain shadow area. Leeward side, rain shadow area, both are same. The side which doesn't receive rainfall, the side which doesn't receive the winds, that side is called as leeward side or rain shadow area. The side which receives the winds, which gets the moisture, that part is called as the windward side. I think, children, it is very clear what are windward side and the leeward sides, children. So that completes the factors affecting, general factors affecting the climate of a place. That completes the, again I am repeating, all the factors which affect the climate of a place, children. Now this is a world map. Now what we are talking about? Now we are talking about the next part of the chapter, that is factors affecting India's climate. Earlier we did factors affecting climate in general, latitude, altitude, all those. Same factors, now we will relate with our country. Factors are same, but we will relate with our country, India. Now, all of you can see why this world map is taken is, this is your, children, world map where the location of India is shown to you. Without seeing the location, you won't be able to understand. For example, this is our equator, 0 degrees. So I'm just reminding you that what is India's location. India lies in the northern part of the world because it is above the equator. So it lies above the equator in the tropical region. Where is our prime meridian, children? This dotted line you can see, this dotted line which is passing through Africa, children. This is your prime meridian longitude. And when we talk about the which hemisphere India lies as per the longitude, India lies in the eastern part. So what is the location of India, children? India's location is northeast in the world. India's location is northeast location in the world. Now what I'm talking about is, what is it which passes through India? Do you know that? Which latitude is passing through the center of our country? What is that called as, children? You have done in the first chapter. Yes, it is called as Tropic of Cancer. It is called as tropic of Cancer, which passes through the middle of the country. So, what is there towards the south of this tropic of Cancer, and what type of climate is there to the south of the tropic of Cancer? South of the tropic of Cancer, that means this region will experience tropical climate. We have done earlier just now tropics and subtropics in the first part. So this is your tropical region, and the region above the tropic of Cancer, the region which is above the tropic of Cancer, children, this region children, is your subtropic region. I'll show you in India map also, which will be more clear. This is, so the northern part of tropic of Cancer experiences subtropical climate. Southern part of India, children, experiences tropical climate. And tropic of Cancer passes through middle of our country from run of Kutch, which is in the western part of India, to Mizoram, which is in the eastern part of India. So I'm repeating, south of tropic of Cancer is tropical area which has a tropical climate. North of the tropic of Cancer is subtropical area, so it has subtropical climate. So India experiences both tropical and subtropical climate. So the question here is, children, why India experiences both tropical and subtropical climate? Why India experiences both tropical and subtropical climate? That's the factor, children, latitude, which affects the climate of India. Latitude, which affects the climate of India. Here you can see, children, this is the same figure which we have done in the first part of the chapter, children. If you remember very clearly, latitudes, all these latitudes, longitudes, all have been written. You know that are the extreme southern latitude. How much is our extreme southern latitude, children? It is 8 degrees 4 minutes north. Now it is very clear, children, you can see here. 8 degrees 4 minutes north. And our northern latitude is 37 degrees 6 minutes north. Then we come to the longitudes. Our extreme western longitude is your 68 degrees 7 minutes east, and our extreme eastern longitude is your 97 degrees 25 east. Why is it east written here? Because the whole of India lies in the eastern hemisphere. Why is it north written here? Because the whole of India is in the northern hemisphere, children. Now, why what I'm showing you is this line which is drawn in the center, this latitude, that is your tropic of Cancer. This line which is drawn, that is your tropic of Cancer, passing from run of Kutch in west to Mizoram in east. So this divides our country into two top regions. That is, this part is your tropical region, tropical climate, and northern India is your subtropical climate. Other than this, children, relief feature I have explained, but I can show you again here the relief feature. For example, we know that these are our Himalayas. Here we have, children, Himalayas. We all have done this. These are our Himalayan ranges. I'm not showing all the ranges because they are not required here. So all these are our Himalayas. Now what I want to say is, the winds which are blowing from Central Asia towards India, Himalayas stop these winds. Because these are cold winds. Because Himalayas stop them, our northern part of India is not a cold desert. Otherwise, it would have been the cold desert. So there is a question here, children. Write, you can write and give the answer for this also. Why Indian subcontinent experience milder winters compared to Central Asia? I am repeating. Why Indian subcontinent experience milder winters? Mild means less wind, not less in amount, it's less in, that means it's not very cold. Milder winters compared to Central Asia. Answer is because Himalayan mountains, they which are in the northern part of India, prevent cold winds from Central Asia from entering the subcontinent. Himalayas, which lie in the northern part of India, they prevent cold winds blowing from Central Asia from entering into the Indian subcontinent. That is why Indian subcontinent experience milder winter as compared to Central Asia. Children, that completes your one more factor which affects the India's climate. Children, I hope till here you have followed, because the next part of the chapter is your pressure and winds. Next part of the chapter is your pressure and winds, for which we need to go back to the figure which we have done in the first earlier part, where I was describing you about these winds, children. Northeasterly trade winds. Now, if we talk about here, now where is India lying? Let's see here now. It's a, as we know, this is your equator. If this is your equator, children, then India lies over here. Okay, children, just I'm trying to draw the map. I think this is, give me 1 minute, I'll draw it again with another color so that it is visible for all of us. Okay. Now, why I have drawn India like this is because to show that which we have India's position over here. Now, we know that the winds which are blowing, which I have told you already, these are your northeasterly trade winds. And India lies in this region of trade winds. So, India is here in this region of trade winds. These winds originate from, which we have already done, subtropical high pressure belt in the northern hemisphere to equatorial low pressure belt in the southern hemisphere. I'm not repeating them because I've already explained. This is your subtropical, H is written. So subtropical, it's not only for horse latitude, it is also for high. So high pressure belt, subtropical high pressure belt is here, equatorial low pressure belt is here. So the winds are flowing from subtropical high pressure belt to equatorial low pressure belt. They blow south. You can see they are blowing towards down. So they blow south, gets deflected to right. So they actually can move straight also, children, like this. But they are not moving straight. They are deflected like this. You can see this, this one which is over here. I'll show you again, children, so that it can be very clear to you by removing these lines once more. You can see, children, the winds can move straight also, but while moving straight, they are deflected. Deflected means they change their direction towards the right. So they are moving towards the right like this. Why is this so? This is because of Coriolis force. Coriolis, Coriolis force. That is force caused by earth rotation. What is Coriolis force, children? It is the force caused by earth rotation. And this law is actually given by a person called as Farrell. So it is also called as Farrell's law. These winds carry very little moisture as they originate and blow on land or dry winds. These winds, they blow towards the equator. Generally, they do not have much of the moisture. So therefore, they bring little or no rain. The question here for you is, after which I am stopping. Now if you see India, India is not receiving, it is receiving very little amount of northeasterly winds. It's rather the eastern northeasterly winds are blowing away from our country. So that means we are not receiving trade winds. We are not receiving any trade winds. That means we are not receiving any moisture. So as per this, India should have been an arid land. India should have been a desert. But it is not so, children. Why is it so? Even if India is not receiving these winds, the permanent winds like trade winds, India is not a desert, not an arid land, not a desert. Why is it so? That you find out. And the next class, we will continue with the next part of the chapter, which is again very interesting, pressure and wind conditions over India. Till now you have done pressure and wind system in the world. Now we will do pressure and wind conditions over India, which will tell you the concept of monsoons. Now that will describe the concept of the monsoons in the next class, children. That's all for today. I hope you have followed and revised everything which I have done. That's all, children. Have a good day.